Good morning and welcome to St. Angela's. Especially our guests and new members, as we begin our new year of grace and prayer, we start with the season of Advent. Advent means coming. Jesus will come again. So we are called upon to be watchful and alert as we await his coming. God promised that Jesus, our Savior and Messiah, would come. So he did at Christmas, but he will come again. And as we are invited to await the fulfillment of God's kingdom, may the Lord guide us in our waiting and remind us of God's and never-ending love. Now, a few notes for the coming week. This week, we celebrate the Immaculate Conception of Mary, a holy day of obligation for Catholics. See our Mass schedule in the bulletin. Please note, our Mass Intentions book is now open for scheduling Masses for the first months of 2024. Choices are limited, so as to be fair to all. Don't forget, our Ladies Guild is doing something different for Christmas giving this year. Instead of giving trees for those in need, they are asking for donations to purchase gift cards to help both the needy and the givers. The deadline for donations is December 3rd. Make checks out to same guild's Ladies Guild. Make the envelopes marked Ladies Guild holiday gift and drop them off at the parish or in the basket. USA invites all high school students to come to the Centennial Hall on this Sunday at 6:45 to 8:15 and experience faith, friendship, and fun. Bring a dollar and a friend and enjoy YOSA experience. Now, as we prepare for worship, we thank you for all for turning off your phones. Today's celebrant for the Mass is Father Rick.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. We enter into this sacred Advent season. We are called upon Christ to watch, to be alert. For those times that we have allowed ourselves to be called into silence and into complacency, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you come in word and in sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you will come again in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Grant your faithful, we pray, Almighty God, the resolve to run forth to meet your Christ with righteous deeds at his coming, so that gathered at his right hand, we they may be worthy to possess the heavenly kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. You, Lord, are our Father, our Redeemer. You are named forever. Why do you let us wander, O Lord, from your ways, and harden our hearts so that we fear you not? Return for the sake of your servants, the tribes of your heritage. Oh, that you would render the heavens and come down with the mountains quaking before you, while you wrought awesome deeds we could not hope for, such as they had not heard of from old. No ear has ever heard, no eye ever seen, any God but you doing such deeds for those who have waited for him. Would that you might meet us doing right, that we were mindful of you in our ways. Behold, you are angry, and we are sinful. All of us have become like unclean people. All our good deeds are like polluted rags. We have all withered like leaves, and our guilt carries us away like the wind. There is none who calls upon your name, who rouses himself to cling to your, for you have hidden your face from us, and you have delivered us up to our guilt. Yet, O Lord, you are our Father. We are the clay, and you are the potter. We are all the work of your hands. The word of the Lord.
Lord, make us turn to you, let us see your face, and we shall be saved.
O Shepherd of Israel, hearken. From your throne upon the cherubim, shine forth, rouse your power, and come to save us. Once again, O Lord of hosts, look down from heaven and see, take care of this vine and protect what your right hand has planted, the Son of Man, whom you yourself made strong. May your help be with the man of your right hand, with the Son of Man, whom you yourself made strong. Then we will no more withdraw from you. Give us new life, and we will call upon your name. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God always on your account for the grace of God bestowed on you in Christ Jesus, that in him you are enriched in every way with all discourse and all knowledge, as the testimony to Christ was confirmed among you, so that you are not lacking in any spiritual gift as you wait for the revelation of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will keep you firm to the end, irreproachable on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful, and by him you are called to the fellowship with his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Show us, Lord, your love and grant us your salvation.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus said to his disciples, "Be watchful, be alert. You do not know when the time will come. It is like a man traveling abroad. He leaves home and places his servants in charge, each with his own work, and orders a gatekeeper to be on the watch. Watch, therefore. You do not know when the Lord of the house is coming, whether in the evening or at midnight or at cockcrow or in the morning. May he not come suddenly and find you sleeping. What I say to you, I say to all. Watch." The Gospel of the Lord. I always feel bad when there's a saint day on a Sunday because then we don't observe it, and I always feel like that one gets cheated. So, today I am expressing my sympathies to St. Francis Xavier, whose feast day is today. So I'll talk about him. St. Francis Xavier was born in the 1500s, was one of the first members of the Society of Jesus, our friends over at St. Ignatius, their spiritual sons. Along with Ignatius of Loyola, Francis was one of the first to enter the society. He was inspired by Ignatius's spirituality. Earlier in his youth, he'd had a deep conversion. He's kind of jolted out of his complacency and moved out to be something more than he was. What that would be would later come to light. As a Jesuit, he became a priest and had a deep desire in his heart to go abroad to spread the gospel. And so he went to India, where he found already an established community of Catholics, but people who became Catholic not for the best of reasons. They did so to ally themselves with the Portuguese in hopes that it would make for a better trade deal for them. But their hearts really weren't in it. They accepted baptism, but they weren't converted. And so Francis Xavier was sent to them to wake them up. Like, hey, do you realize what happened to you? And how you are called to live your life? His fervor drew 20,000 more people to be baptized by his hand in India. 20,000 people. I've only baptized a little over 100 in 5.5 years. So I've got a long way to go. But Francis Xavier would continue on to Japan, where his zeal, his fervor for Christ inspired thousands more to accept the faith. Why do I talk about Francis Xavier? Not just because it's his feast day today, but because I think he's a person who exemplifies the gospel proclaimed today. The gospel today is very short. It's only 6 sentences. And yet, we hear the word watch 5 times. So, kids, if your parents ask you, what was the gospel about today? You got an easy answer. Watch. But what does that mean? What does it mean to watch? What does it mean? What are we talking about? What are we watching for? What are we watching for? Oh, my children's choir wants to answer my questions. Oh, all right, I'll bite. What am I watching for, guys? Yes?
You're watching for Jesus to come back to earth.
Oh, my goodness. I'm watching for Jesus to come back to earth. Absolutely. Absolutely. I'm watching for Christ to come back. What else am I... What can I do right now? Jesus might not be back for a while. Heads up. He may not be back for a little bit. But in the meantime, like Francis Xavier, what can I do? What can I do right now, like St. Francis did? Yes! To do good stuff. Yes, I can do good stuff. What kind of good stuff? What kind of good stuff can I do? Yes! Yes, that's a very good thing. Yes. How about my faith? What do I do with my faith? Is it just for me? Children's choir, tell me. Is my faith just for me? What am I supposed to do with it? Can you all say it together?
Yes.
Beautiful. They get it. Let's let them inspire us to share it, to bring it out to others. To wake up the world, to get people excited about what's really important. You know, it's so easy as we go about our daily lives to just kind of do the little stuff that's in front of us. You know, we wake up in the morning, we go to school, we go to work, we get home, we make dinner, we try to attend to our tasks, and life can just pass us by. Without really thinking, what's my purpose? What's most important? What am I supposed to do with this precious life that I've been given? Without answering the most important questions. This Advent is an opportunity for us to wake up, to listen to what's really important, and to reevaluate our lives and say, okay, what needs to change in me so that my life can conform with my ultimate purpose, with my ultimate goal. That is heaven. And not only just for me, but to share that gift with everyone. Let us pray, brothers and sisters, that through the intercession of Saint Francis Xavier, that we would be people who are on fire, who are alert. Let us pray that we would be watchful in this Advent to the things that are truly important. Let us pray that we have the courage to embrace conversion in our own lives, so that we may be more and more people who are awake. Together we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Confident that Christ will come again, we implore him to hear our needs.
Our response is, come, Lord Jesus. For the church, the people of God, and for Pope Francis, may we be alert to this Advent season to our need for God's love and mercy. We pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus.
For patience during this Advent season, may our minds and hearts be focused upon prayer, the people we love, and the people we serve. We pray to the Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus.
For those of us who have wandered away from God, that our prayers and hopes of this season and new year will open a doorway to God who loves them unconditionally. And for our friends celebrating Hanukkah this week, we pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus.
For world leaders, that they may take the long view of human history and choose to protect and promote life and true peace for all people and nations, and for an end of war, hatred, violence, human trafficking, and discrimination, we pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus.
For all who are suffering from violence, famine, persecution, or neglect, for all who are awaiting the birth of a child, that God will bless expectant parents, for an increase of vocations to the priesthood, and may civil dialogue and true respect grow each day in this new year of grace. We pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus.
For all first responders, for our family members in military service, for those who serve the suffering and neglected of this world, and for the care and renewal of our fragile planet, we pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus.
For the sick and suffering, especially Beth Palomsky, Maureen Baterna, Tony Minnelli, Grace Dye, Ann McDonald, Ella Burns, Kathy Reynolds, Betty Logue, Marcella Lowry, Kimberly Yeager, Beverly Baum, Ava Ivani, Charles Lanning, Lucille Citro, Lisa Grow, we pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus.
For the faithful departed, especially Marlene Turchek, Teresa Helfrich, Joan DiPolo, Frank G. Nunn, and all victims of war and natural disasters, we pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus.
And for Danny and Tommy Kokon and Tony D'Onofrio, the intention of this Mass, and for our own personal intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus. Lord our God, we praise you for your Son, Jesus Christ. He is Emmanuel, the hope of the peoples. He is the wisdom that teaches and guides us. He is the Savior of every nation. Lord God, let your blessing come upon us as we light the candles of this wreath. May the wreath and its light be a sign of Christ's promise to bring us salvation. May he come quickly and not delay. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Please join in singing number 39, our offertory song, O Come, Emmanuel, number 39.
Thank you, girls.
In cloud and majesty.
rejoice, rejoice.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, we pray, O Lord, these gifts, these offerings we make, gathered from among your gifts to us. And may what you grant us to celebrate devoutly here below gain for us the prize of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice would be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Francis Xavier, St. Angela Merici, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant, Francis our Pope and Edward our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Miserere nobis. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, miserere nobis. On you stay, you take away the sins of the world. Dona nobis pacem.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Blood and soul and divinity you give as gift to us. Now we become you whom we receive. In you we place our trust.
Lord.
Lord, I am not worthy. Lord, I am not worthy.
As we ready the
Let us pray. May these mysteries, O Lord, in which we have participated, profit us, we pray, for even now as we walk amid passing things, you teach us by them to love the things of heaven and hold fast to what endures, through Christ our Lord. For our blessing, I want to acknowledge our children's choir. This is their first time singing at a Sunday Mass. Didn't they do a wonderful job? We are grateful for them leading us in song. The Lord be with you. Bow down for the blessing. May the Almighty and merciful God, by whose grace you have placed your faith in the first coming of his only begotten Son and yearn for his coming again, sanctify you by the radiance of Christ's advent and enrich you with his blessing. Amen. As you run the race of this present life, may he make you firm in faith, joyful in hope, and active in charity. So that rejoicing now with devotion at the Redeemer's coming in the flesh, you may be endowed with the rich reward of eternal life when he comes again in majesty. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever. Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Please join in singing our closing song, number 42, Come Thou Long Expected Jesus, number 42.